We're going to take a really close look at adding two complex numbers. And we have to take a close look because in the last lesson we got a bit of a surprise. Started with a non-zero real number like 2, and then we added on an imaginary number like 9i, and we couldn't simplify it at all. We had to invent a whole new kind of number, complex number, to handle what happens when we add those two together. Now, what happens when we add two complex numbers? Do we have to invent a whole new number for that? That would be terrible. Then we have to add, you know, if we added two of those new kinds of numbers, we might have to define another new kind of number, then another new kind of number, and we turn math class into vocabulary class. Nobody wants that. So let's add these complex numbers, see what happens. Now, one nice thing about addition is it's commutative. Another nice thing is that it's associative. It's just a fancy way of saying we can remove these parentheses and write this as 2 plus 9i plus 3. Minus 17i, and then we can swap the 3 and the 9i here and write it like this. And what we're doing here is we're putting the pieces together that we know how to add. We know how to add 2 and 3, that gives us 5. We know how to add 9i and minus 17i, break out a little distributive property, we factor that I out. 9 minus 17 is negative 8, and we have 5 minus 8i. Of course, you probably won't write in all these intermediate steps. You'll see the 9i minus the 17i, and you'll go, aha, minus 8i. But now look what happened here. We added these two complex numbers, and our sum is another complex number. We don't have to invent a whole new kind of number. We add two complex numbers, we get a complex number. And we can see pretty quickly what we actually did here. We took the real parts, 2 and the 3, we added those together, we got 5. Then we took the imaginary pieces, the 9i and the minus 17i. 9i minus 17i gives us the minus 8i. So now that we can handle adding two complex numbers, let's take a look at subtracting one from another. Well, once again, we take away the parentheses as our first step. We get 6 plus 14i. Now over here, we have to be careful. We're going to distribute that negative. We're going to subtract the negative 8. And we're going to subtract the 2i. We have to be very careful with our signs. And let's see, we have 6. Go ahead and take care of those negatives. Minus a negative 8, that gives us a plus 8. And minus a 2i, that's just a minus 2i. Again, we put together the real pieces, 6 plus 8. Put together the imaginary pieces, plus 14i minus 2i. 6 plus 8 is 14. 14i minus 2i is 12i. Now we can go back and check. 6 minus a negative 8. 6 plus 8 is 14. 14i minus 2i is 12i. So now we have adding complex numbers down. We have subtracting complex numbers down. Let's look at something slightly more complicated. Start off just with the distributive property. Negative 3 times 7, minus 3 times minus 5i, plus 8 times 4, plus 8 times minus 3i. Very important here, just make sure you get your signs right. Negative times a positive, negative 3 times positive 7 is negative 21. Negative 3 times a negative 5i, negative 3 times a negative 5i, it's going to give us a plus 15i. 8 times 4 is 32. 8 times a negative 3i. 8 times a negative 3i is minus 24i. And you know the drill from here. We put the real parts together, and we put the imaginary pieces together. Negative 21 plus 32, that gives us 11. 15i minus 24i gives us a minus 9i. So we've got adding complex numbers down, subtracting them, we got that too. Got a little more complicated arithmetic here. So we can add them, we can subtract them. You know what comes next? We're going to multiply them.